Hong Kong people actually do not like to have major disorderly situation. Protest organizer and the police would have some sort of consensus.
There are three major events that's become a turning point of the whole situation. First, of course, will be 12th of June.Protesters, they staged more determined and louder protests than ever before. And the police were a little bit taken by surprise that how many protesters actually gathered on ground in the beginning of June. We saw the first serious confrontation between the protesters and the police. And indeed, that was the first round of smoke being fired.
This actually aroused.The concern and even a suspicion, possible power abuse of the police.
The tactics used by the protesters is nothing really new. They dressed in blacks, they gathered together, they're using whatever available resources on the street, making their barricades.Making their weapons. Throughout the whole of July, we saw the protesters start using new tactics, new type of equipment. For example, we saw very powerful laser pointers being used by protesters pointing at police. We saw police, they become more determined of making arrests rather than just holding the line, being shouted at, being abused of by the protesters.They're making more proactive actions to disperse the crowd from the street.
Some kind of action actually are really, really controversial, and it indiscriminately affect not only the protester, but also the general public, like the extensive use of tear smoke, the rubber bullets, like bean bullets in densely populated areas.
On the 21st of July, we saw a group of citizens wearing white T-shirts making very, very brutal and aggressive attack on the black T-shirt at the Yuelong train station. And unfortunately, the police didn't respond as speedily as they could have. And that generated even worse response from the protesters in terms of they become more violent, pointing a finger at the police that they were collaborating with the gangsters here in Hong Kong, called the Triad. The protesters start throwing petrol bombs, they start attacking the station, they're throwing bricks, and even now they're using slingshots.Now using Nifty location protest up to about 8 or 9 locations at the same time. They're using on the social media platform to attack the police officers' families as well. Seeing the escalation by the protester, they have no choice to escalate their level of force as well in order to protect the safety of the police officers as well as the premises.Police officers are still human beings. They have built up some grudges and anger themselves as well. That make the 11th of August look pretty ugly.
The police took some really extraordinary action, like smash into the MTR station, the use of tear smoke extensively in the MTR station, even the use of undercover to arrest key protesters.
Hong Kong police start using this higher level of force to de-escalate the situation. But I'm afraid we do not see any improvement. Instead, I think we created more grievances as well as angers from the members of the public. It is like you're climbing up a ladder. Your left hand will climb up the next one, the right hand will climb the one higher.
They are fearful of the potential development of the other parties. This sort of anxiety and unpredictability, the police takes action that may be excessively violent. And at the same time, like the chaos from the airport, protesters are also more fearful about potential spies. They actually have the tendency to take more uncontrollable emotional and, to some extent, violent action. The government, what have they done, did not satisfy the demand of the public. This actually breaks down the foundation of mutual trust. And there is no quick fix. If there is a period that may allow both parties to cooling down, that would be better. But I think the major solution should be the leaders. They come out to settle the issue, to resolve the issue by a political means. This kind of political gesture and decision that may eventually de-escalate this kind of unpredictable disruption to the society.